The German war is at an end.
After our victory over the Nazis in Europe, the government has set out to rebuild a Britain fit for heroes. The coal fields of northern England have long been the heartbeat of the British economy, but were notorious for the dangerous conditions and poor wages. But that will soon be changed forever as the nationalization of the mines means, for the very first time, the great British coal industry is owned by the great British people.
This great scheme of nationalization is for all our people and all our children, and it depends on you.
Today, Margaret Thatcher hardened her position against her party's old enemy, the National Union of Mine Workers.
The decision was taken as part of our expenditure policy.
Drawing up her battle plans against the unions and meetings with Michael Heseltine and the rest of the cabinet, it's clear a struggle is to come.
Are you going to accept it down on your knees? Or are you going to stand and fight and oppose the closure and the butchery of your industry?
Through the dark and through the hunger, through the night and through the fear, through the fight and years of hardship, through the storms and through the tears. And although your feet are weary, and although your soul is worn, and although they'll try to break ya, and although you'll feel alone, we will always stand together in the dark, right through the storm. We will stand shoulder to shoulder to keep us warm.
Any news?
Stars look down and the mean and the hungry, and the stars look down and show the way. And the stars look down and we'll stand together to see a day when the stars look down upon our history, and the stars look down upon our past, and the stars look down to see our future bright at last. We stand as one beneath the sun.
And though our hands are bruised and bleeding, and we're lungs,
and our lungs
we're full with dust,
are full with dust,
and
we're hearts
are near to breaking,
We will never,
forgo the trust. Thank you.
We will always stand together through the frost, the hail, the snow.
And although we've been
wrist at last. And we will stand there proudly, and we will never walk alone. And we will be returned back to our home.
Shut up.
And the stars look down at the reflection, and the stars look down at the light, and the stars look down at the justice and the right, and the stars look down at the struggle, and the stars look down at your pain, and the stars will lead to where light shines again when we stand as one beneath the sun.
One
beneath the sun.
Where we stand as one,
all out together.
Where we stand as one,
all out as one.
Where we stand as one,
all out for victory.
Where we stand as one,
till we've won.
Where we stand as one,
all out together.
Where we stand as one,
all out as one.
Where we stand as one,
all out for victory.
Where we stand as one,
till we've won.
Where we stand as one,
all out.
We'll meet back here tomorrow at 8 o'clock. Davey, can you give me a lift?
Tomorrow, remember, we'll meet tomorrow morning at the corner at 10 a.m. And don't be late!
If you have any questions, come and see me. We've got to work together to make this change happen. This is what we've been waiting for, lads!
Ready.
Coming!
Tony, what the hell are you doing?
Nothing, reading.
We're supposed to be on the bloody picket line in 5 minutes.
We're gonna win anyway, get off me back.
As soon as you get off your fat arse, Billy, you're gonna be late, son.
I said I'm coming.
Leave the bear alone, will ya?
Billy, I'm warning ya. Oh, Grandma, what are you doing?
I'm looking for me pasty.
Forget about your bloody pasty. Sit down. Making you a nice cooked breakfast. Feet off the table.
Have you seen me, Pasty?
Billy, get downstairs now or I'll turn your hide for you.
Conan, what that boy needs is a mother's touch.
What that boy needs is a good kick up the arse. Sit down. What's your bloody breakfast?
I don't want a cooked breakfast.
Billy!
Not your cooked breakfast.
Conan!
Oh, no. Will you look at the state of this?
The food in this house has been inedible since your mom died.
Grandma.
Oh, leave us alone, will you? I'm the only one who does any bloody work in this house.
Two burnt slices of fried bread?
It's an egg, actually.
I paid for that.
All property is theft, comrade.
Good morning, Edna.
Oh, what's good about it? They purloined me pasty.
Oh, bugger off a lot of yous. You're eating us out of house and home.
Boy, the police are busting the scabs in Arley. Come on.
Billy, your 50p for boxing is on the side there. You, picket line, now.
Maggie.
Waste not, want not.
Hello, Grandma.
Hello, son.
Grandma, I found this in the laundry basket.
What the hell is that?
It's your pasty.
Thank the Lord, I thought I'd eaten it.
Nobody eat that, Grandma. It's mine.
You lot have it too bloody easy. I can remember the general strike.
What you doing? Look, it's got mold on it. You make yourself ill if you eat that. You're driving me mental. Anyway, how come you can remember the general strike, but you can't remember where you put your pasty?
Oh!
Grandma!
That is disgusting!
Where you going now?
Oh, I have a nice sausage roll on the landing.
Oh, little one, what have I told you about drinking out of the bottle?
Hello, ma'am.
Will you look at the state of this kitchen?
I know.
You're gonna be late.
Ma'am.
Have you got your 50p?
Dad gave us it.
Have you got your trainers?
Yeah. No.
They'll be in your bedroom.
No, they're not.
Billy.
I'm absolutely positive they're not. Found them.
You'd forget your head if it was loose.
I think Grandma must have moved them. They've got muck all over them. Ma'am? Ma'am?
Oi! Bollocks!
Get off us, man!
Come on, you lazy little buggers! It's boxy, for Christ's sake! Rory, drop down there and give me something!
Oh, no! What bloody time you call this?
Go on, get changed now!
Do I have to?
Of course you have to! You haven't done any boxing yet!
Well, it's nearly finished!
Get changed, or I'll knock your block off!
Ow!
Do you call them press-ups, you lazy little git?
I've seen more life in Maggie Thatcher's knickers. Right, piss off. Oi, where do you think you're going?
I'm pissing off.
You're pissing me off. You can stay where you are and fight sugar with it over there.
I'm thinking up to 2,000.
Serves you right over here now. Oi, Michael!
But I need the toilet, sir.
Not my fault. I was late. I had to see my nana.
I'll see to your bleeding nana in a minute. Do you think I do these classes for the good of my health? Anybody think you don't even like boxing?
I don't.
50p, you bony man. You're gonna get your 50p's worth, whether you like it or not.
But look, everybody else is going home.
Aye, cause that's cause they don't need boxing.
See you, George.
See you, sunshine.
Oi,
Michael! Where do you think you're going?
To get changed!
Oh, for Christ's sake! Get back here now! Right! You stand there. You stand there. Now, hit him!
Do I have to?
Of course you have to hit him! It's boxing! Now go on, whack him one, or else I'll tell your dad on you. What, man?
Please, sir, maybe what?
You can have two. Bugger, end off.
Ow! His dad doesn't even like him coming.
You can shut your cake hole as well, all right, smart aleck? All right, let's do this. Ding, ding, ding. Round one. Come on, let's do a little boxing. That's what we're here to do. That's it. Come on, let's put a little beef into it. And then we'll just... Whoa, whoa, whoa! What the hell are you doing, John Travolta?
I'm just trying to put him up.
It's not a bloody tea dance, man. Hit him in the head.
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure! Go on, whack, little bastard!
Ow!
That's a good one! Come on, get up.
Sorry, Billy!
Sorry. Sorry? What the hell do you mean, sorry? He's supposed to hit you. You're supposed to hit him. It's boxing!
Ow!
Oh, for Christ's sake!
Are you all right?
He's all right, you great bat bunny! Right! Hit him back!
I don't really want to.
God, give me strength. All right, Michael, let's show him how it's done. Here to the left, and the right. And let the left! You little bastard!
Sorry, dog!
Go on, piss off!
where you are!
But that was just about
to
go home.
No buts about it. You're a disgrace to your father, to them gloves, to the fine traditions of this boxing hall.
Right, I'm off to the picket line. You can stay here and practice by yourself.
Oh, aye. And make sure Miss Wilkins will get things cased before you leave.
Who? Give a fig. Come on, son, get over.
do.
What for?
For your lesson? You don't think I was doing that for the good of me health, do ya?
That wasn't a lesson.
Of course it was a bloody lesson that nearly killed me. Now admittedly, your fan work wasn't so hot, but you've got quite a nice turnout.
What?
50p, stop pissing about.
I haven't got 50p, I spent it on boxing.
Very well then, bring it next week.
What you mean next week?
Well, you're coming again, aren't ya?
You've got to be joking. To this crap?
Please, your Bessie. Oi, Debbie, bring me stuff.
So, do you reckon?
You look like a wanker to me.
Somewhere. You must have hidden it.
Grandma, that's me private stuff.
What is it?
Nothing. It's private. Mam gave it to me.
Where's she gone?
She's dead, Grandma. You were at the funeral.
Was I?
Of course you were. She was buried next to Granddad.
Not him at all. Christ, Billy, they're dropping like flies.
For heaven's sake.
Got you a pasty.
Oh, really?
From the co-op. Just don't tell Dad I was late or anything.
Come off it. Do you really not remember about Granddad?
Of course I do, Billy. We were married for 33 years. How could I forget your grandpa?
So, what was he like?
He was a complete bastard. I hated the sod for 33 years. We should never have married. Of that, I'm quite clear. He spent the housekeeping money on whiskey and beer, and he never lifted a finger. Times were hard, but the swine rolled back pissed, so he'd fight, and he'd swing, and he rarely missed. So I clobbered the sod when he couldn't resist. Asleep, you can't lift a finger. But we go dancing, and he'd hold me tight. He was air, he was water, he was breath, he was light. And he would hold me close with all his might. And it was bliss for an hour or so. Then they called time to go. And in the morning, we were sober. Oh, he'd drink and he'd talk just like a fool. Lie like a man and snore like a mule. Rarely was sober, pretty much was the rule. And he never lived. I suppose times were hard, things were different then. Women were women, and men, they were men. 17, that was it, your life ended when you had a ring around your finger. We go dancing, he was my old friend now, and for a moment, there I was melancholy. We had
an hour or three from the people we had to be. But in the morning, we were sober. I'd do it without the help of men, or at least your granddad, but then again, you know, it's best not to linger. What is the use of dreaming now? I had my chance, well, anyhow, if I only know then what I know now, I'd have given them all the finger and gone dancing and not give a shit. Spin the rock and reel and love every bit, and I'd dance alone and enjoy it, and I'd be me for an entire life instead of somebody's wife. And I never
she's doing here?
Keeping the peace.
What's for like? There's an out going on.
Well, we're doing a bloody good job then, aren't we? Now, sod off.
So, are you gonna go back then?
What? To Bali?
Plenty of lads do Bali.
Puffs.
Not necessarily.
Who like?
What about that Rudolf Nureyev? He's not a puff.
Anyway, I don't know why you bother going. You're crap at it.
No, I'm not. Anyway, it's not like I have much of a choice, do I?
Debbie, get a move on. How'd you put up with her?
Hey, how would you like it if I slagged off your man?
Me mam's dead.
Oh. See you then.
Everybody, positions, please. Girls to the front, and 5, 6, 7, 8, rocking the baby.
Sorry.
Stretch. Get rid of the pie, Tracy Atkinson. Lovely. Debbie, you're late, girl. And washing those windows. And 5, 6, 7, 8.
Hello?
Hello. Shoes.
Haven't got any.
Ah, oh well. And 5, 6, 7, 8. Debbie, count, girl, for Christ's sakes.
What am I supposed to do?
Follow the others. And air in those sheets. And hang them on the other line. lovely.
Miss, I don't know what I'm supposed to
get
do.
Get down. And 5, 6, 7, 8.
What am I supposed to do?
You follow the others.
I don't know what I'm doing.
Floor bar.
What bar?
Floor bar.
What?
Get down,
know
Billy.
What I'm
Elliot.
To do.
Karen, point those toes. All right, girls. Here we go. And 5, 6, 7, 8, and ladies, plie, go. Now, tendu second, plie, tendu close, develop a devant left leg.
Oh, Joey, wanna see something you never seen before?
Right leg.
And that's just on the overtime. Wanna see some more?
Left keep looking at that spot, so your head is the last thing to leave and the first thing to come back. Is that understood?
Yes, miss.
Right. Why the hell do I bother? All right, into the middle. Thank you, Mr. Braithwaite. And here we go. And...
Looks like a spastic starfish girl.
Tommy? Jim.
Please, ma'am. May we have a go?
Right. Baskets of pansies, ladies. Oh, yes, thank you, Mr. Braithwaite. And 5, 6, 7, 8. Thank you.
phoned you that for? Now I'm banned. I don't even want to go to your stupid valley anyway. I'm not even any good at it.
Oh, bullshit, Billy Elliot.
Well, it's not.
That's absolute bullshit, and you know it. Listen, this might sound a bit weird, but I've been thinking about the Royal Valley School.
The Royal what?
The Royal Valley School.
Aren't you a bit told, miss?
For me, a stupid idiot, for you. They have regional auditions soon in Newcastle.
Well, what about me, Dad?
Listen, it would take a lot of work, but I figured if you had some proper lessons with me on your own, you'd have a chance of getting in.
But I've only just learned to pirouette.
God's sakes, they're not looking for something fully formed that's let from the brow of Zeus. They're looking for potential. They teach you the ballet.
But I'm banned, miss.
For Christ's sakes, get out here.
Shit, you can't come in here.
Listen, just come after school. Nobody else needs help.
You don't fancy me, do you, miss?
No, funnily enough, I don't.
I don't know if I've got the time to go. I mean, I know that I out and stuff.
Listen, Billy, if you want to stick around here and piss about with your mates, it's fine by me. I'll be here Monday night. Go on, get some things, and we'll make up a special dance for the audition.
What sort of things?
Does it mean something to you? Things that tell me a little bit about who you are. See you Monday then? Saw you then, if I care.
Michael! Bloody hell!
What?
You're wearing a dress?
I know.
Is it yours?
Of course it's not mine, you stupid idiot. It's my sister's. Do you want to go?
No. Look, I need to talk to you.
Are you sure? You can borrow one of my mounts.
What you doing?
I'm just trying it on ya. Oh, sword ways, that's disgusting.
Michael.
Hold it.
Won't we get in trouble?
It'll be bollocks. My dad does it all the time.
Remember that week I had to stay behind after boxing?
Oi!
When I had to give that woman the keys?
Come here.
I did some ballet.
You did ballet?
Just a few steps in that.
Oh, it's not a way if you ask me. Bingo! Separate! Cush! Trainers off!
The woman says I'm good at it. She's asked us to do an audition for the Royal Ballet School.
The Royal what?
The Royal Ballet School.
Did you get to where you do?
Don't be daft, I'm wearing shorts.
Cush! Have you done this before?
Have I, bullocks?
Smile!
Wait, what you doing?
One for the elbow! Yeah, put this on! Arms!
So, do you think I should go back and do the audition then?
Oh, I wouldn't if I were you. Give on my thank you mental!
But you dress up in women's clothing!
Well, that's different!
Is it?
Of course it is! Time for a look in the mirror!
Go on then.
Oh, hold on a minute. The finishing touch.
You're crying out loud.
You see, man, there's nothing wrong with dressing up in women's clothing. Is it sinful if you're blue to cheer up the place? What is wrong with dressing up in satin and lace?
Oh, no.
Get some earrings. Some mascara, heels and a fan. Pretty soon you will start to feel a different man. Olay, baby! What the hell's wrong with expressing yourself? Being who you want to be. Come on, join in! Will anybody die if you put on a dress? Who the hell cares if your blush is a mess? Start a new fashion, book all the trends, emphasize integrity, shake up shoulders, Billy.
On top your pop.
Woo! What the hell's wrong with dressing yourself? dress. All you have to do is learn to care less. Start a new fashion, book all the trends. Amazing something to me. Woo! What the hell's wrong with expressing yourself? For wanting to be free. If you want to be a dancer, dance. If you want to be a minor, mine. If you want to dress like somebody else, fine, fine, fine. It's not a statement, it's not a weird act, just a good idea at the time. We'll not complain about your boring life if you'll just leave it to mine. If you want to be a dancer, dance.
Shiggity, shiggity. If you want to be a minor, mine.
Better than that.
Like what?
Like this.
How's that? Not bad.
You ain't seen nothing yet.
One, two, three, four.
Do with you.
Hasn't it? You're going nowhere with that.
Don't you tell me what to do.
Just put it back, son.
Look! This isn't bloody Disneyland, Dead Man! You wanna go down there? Get the shit kicked out of you? Let's go pigeon.
Don't be so bloody stupid, son.
There are 2,000 police on the doorstep! Did you see what they did to Harry Robson? They broke both his bloody legs, man!
You're not going down there. The last thing we need is you in the hospital. Just put it back, son.
Make us.
I said, put it back.
What you gonna do, like? Hit us? Well, come on, then. Come on! No. You've been a complete waste of space since Mam died.
Stop it! Stop it, please!
What the bloody hell are you looking at?
I thought you weren't going to show.
I had to wait until my dad went out.
Well, better late than never, but let's get started. Did you bring your things for the dance?
I brought some things, but I didn't really know what you meant.
All right, well, let's see then. Rubik's Cube. Star Trek Annual.
Yeah.
Baked beans? What's that?
It's a packet of soup, miss.
What the hell's that for?
I don't know.
Billy, I asked you to bring things that mean something to you.
I know.
How the bloody hell am I supposed to make up a dance about baked beans and a packet of soup?
Don't you know, miss.
Look, at the risk of sounding totally boring, dance is as much about you discovering things about yourself as it is discovering about dancing, do you understand?
What?
Listen, it's not just about the steps. It's about you.
Well, what does it have to be about me for?
Jesus Christ, because I said so. What's this?
It's a letter.
I can see it's a letter.
Hmm? You can open it if you want.
Oh, thank God for that. The suspense was killing me.
It's from me, ma'am.
Your mom?
Yeah. She wrote it to us when I was 18, but I opened it a few years early.
I see.
You can read it if you want. Read it out.
Dear Billy, I must seem a distant memory. Which is probably a good thing. And it will have been a long,
long time.
And I will have missed you growing, and I'll have missed you crying, and I'll have missed you laugh. Missed your stomping and your shouting. I'll have missed telling you off. But please, Billy, know that I was always there. I was with you through everything. And please, Billy, know that I will always be proud to have known you. Proud that you were mine, proud in everything, and you must promise me this, Billy. In everything you do, always be yourself, Billy, and you always will be true, and I'll have missed you growing. I'll have missed you crying, and I'll have missed you laugh. Missed your stomping and your shouting. I'll have missed telling you off. But please, Billy, know that I was always there. I was with you through everything. And please, Billy, know that I will always be proud to have known you. Love you forever.
Love you forever.
She must have been a very special woman.
No, she was just me, ma'am.
Right.
good start.
All right. Mr. Braithwaite. Ah, I thought you'd abandon us.
I just got a little detained at the Rose and Crown.
What is he doing here?
Oh, you're gonna need something to dance to, aren't you? You little wanker.
See, Billy, there are two basic theories about dance. The first is, it's a purely technical exercise, something you just learn from the outside and repeat. Or it's a very personal expression that you realize from within.
What's she on about?
Well, basically it was all down to Diaghilev, who ran the ballet Russe. And he wanted to revolutionize what would become a purely decorative medium and reconnect it to dance's chthonic roots as a primordial means of expression.
He took an evening class at Sunderland Coley. What Mr. Braithwaite means is you have to release your inner caveman, and then everything will just flow naturally. Yeah? Hit it, Mr. Braithwaite. We weren't born to stand still.
Yes.
Ain't a question of will.
What you doing?
Gotta move, it's a fact. We were born to react. We weren't made to behave like you will in the grave. When the music is played, oh, your soul will be swayed, and your feet, they will move as if only to prove that it was by chance, we were destined to dance. We were born to bouquet. We were born to bouquet. It ain't a puzzle, but we're blood and muscle. Day of creation, we were the dance sensation.
We're the natural proper dancing.
Mr.
ma'am said that was cush.
I wouldn't listen to her. She's sexually frustrated.
Really?
Me dad was caught shagging this woman at work, but now he's an alcoholic.
I got off, will ya?
Billy?
What?
Do you not fancy me?
I don't know. I guess I never really thought about it.
If you'd like, I'd show you me fatty.
Nah, it's okay.
Debbie, outside. All right, Billy, here's the tape. Now, once the audition starts, do exactly what you're doing here and you should be fine.
I know, Miss, you've taught us before.
Another thing, Billy, try and keep your mouth shut. All right, I'll be here tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock, all right?
All right.
And Billy, you can do this. You've worked so hard, and I know you can do it. You have to forget about everything else and do it for you. Right. Right. So, be here tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock, and for God's sakes, don't be late. You have to be at Newcastle at 9 o'clock.
Don't worry, miss.
And another thing.
It's my mom on.
Right.
To a hospital.
How the hell are we going to get him to hospital?
They've got the whole place surrounded, man.
Can't stay. Give her after him.
What's going on?
It's all kicked off. There's about 100 police coming through the village.
Get off me, will you?
What's happened to him?
What does it bloody look like?
Where do you think you're going dressed like that?
Out.
You're not going anywhere today. Back upstairs.
But I said I'd see Michael.
You're not stepping foot outside this
but
house.
But Dad, I said
you're
I'd
back see upstairs now!
You're right, Baran.
Jesus Christ, do something, man!
Shit!
What the bloody hell is the matter with you?
Hello.
Hello.
Can I come
what
in?
What the hell do you think you're
what the hell is going on, Billy?
Hey, miss.
No, I stood outside the welfare for half an hour. Come on.
What the bloody hell is going on here?
Please leave me alone, miss.
No, Billy, we have to go. There's police cars blocking the street and everything.
Hang on a minute. Go where?
Oh, no.
Will someone tell me what the hell's going on here?
Just go away.
Billy, I think it's time we sort this out once and for all. Now, I realize this will be difficult for you to understand, but I think I have to tell you.
No, miss!
Billy has an audition this morning for the Royal Ballet School.
I beg your pardon? The Royal Ballet?
School, where they teach the ballet.
Oh.
You must be joking, though!
No, Billy's been coming to class and I've been giving him private lessons for the past 2 months.
What?
I know it was stupid and I
should. Hang on a minute! Who gave you permission to teach him ballet?
Excuse me, Mr. Elliot, but we're missing the audition as we speak.
Have you any idea what we're going through in this village? Ballet! What are you trying to do? Make him a scab the rest of his life? Look at him. He's only a bit of a crazy.
You've got to start training from when you're young.
Shut it, you! I'm not having any brother of mine pouncing around for your gratification.
Excuse me, this is not for my gratification. Billy is exceptionally talented.
You're not taking him anywhere. He's only a bear. What's wrong with giving him a childhood?
I don't want a childhood! I want to be a ballet dancer.
I'll give you a bloody childhood in a minute.
And anyway, what do you know about it? Teaching 10-year-olds in a school gym? What kind of qualification have you got?
I haven't come here to defend myself in front of you.
You could be another for all I know.
I think you should calm yourself down, son.
What? You say you can dance? Well, let's just sit and stand and don't get up there!
No, Billy, don't you
go
dare.
On, then! If you're a bloody ballet dancer, let me have you!
No, this is ridiculous, don't
what
you?
Sort of ballet teacher are you? This is his big chance! Dance, you little bastard!
No!
No! He says he doesn't want to dance. So, that's it then. We'll be having no more of this ballet! And if I see you come anywhere near him again, I'll smack you one, you middle-class cow!
Now you hang on a minute. You don't know anything about me, you sanctimonious little shit. What are you all afraid of? That Billy won't grow up to raise whippets or grow leeks or piss his wages up the wall? I've been with this boy every night for weeks now. And you haven't even noticed. So don't you lecture me about the British class system, comrade.
Tony, the police are coming down the street. Everyone,
shut up,
now!
Oh, shit.
I'm sorry, darling. But you haven't got a hope in hell. Bastard.
Me ma'am would have let us!
Your ma'am's dead.
Thank you.
More dollars, though. We can do something with that. I mean, look at these kids. Give it up for the kids, right? I mean, right? Yeah. It's incredible the first half, huh? Yeah. So, how'd you guys do?
We're not right.
We got a dollar.
You lost a change!
I know you didn't give us money.
Oh, I'm looking at you. I'm looking definitely at you. All right, you guys, listen. We're doing this for you, the show, the strike, of course. I mean, it's trickle down, right? Economics, the money. You know, this is over your head. We've been on strike for nearly a year now. But are we downhearted?
Yes.
Are we downhearted?
No.
Are we downhearted?
Yes.
Now. Welcome back to the second half. The second half of
the Easy Miners and Wolf Christmas Show!
Looked over vales and hills, saw
saw myself a future of riches and of thrills. But on me 15th birthday, I paid me union dues. They sent me deep into the ground. Oh, the winter wind can blow me colder. Oh, the summer heat can parch me dry. But I'll not be here for a fortune. I shall never leave it till I die. Oh, once I had the family, sons to make you proud. They have gone and left me now. Now I am an old man, just waiting for me turn, till they take me back into the ground. Oh, the winter wind can blow me colder, oh, the summer heat can parch me dry, but I'll not leave here.
Gave you that impression. burnt me hands cold. Quite like it.
Just because I like ballet doesn't mean I'm a puff, you know?
You won't tell anyone, will ya?
Here. Put this on.
Can I?
Gosh!
It'll be a little while. Oh, it's a bit small. Where's the leg? Oh, I'm not sure this green will go with me too.
Shut up, man.
I think he never won a tutu before. It's very small. Come on, do some dancing then.
Whoa, told ya. I've packed it in.
Come on, just a little bit. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. Just a little bit! Oh, no wonder they call it a nutcracker!
It's hot, man.
Oh, come on! Do some bloody dancing then!
Whoa, we'd best be going. My dad will be after us.
Your dad is as drunk as a skunk, man.
You should go.
Right where the last you are. If you like, you can keep the tutu. Can I? Yes.
You're not gonna go home in it, are ya?
Of course I am. No one will notice. See you then.
See ya, Michael.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you. do you want?
I was hoping to talk to Mrs. Wilkinson.
Sandra, friend of yours.
Oh, hello.
So, how much is it going to cost then?
And a Merry Christmas to you too.
I've just been doing a lot of thinking.
That must have come as a shock to the system. Piss off, Debbie, I'm busy.
I know. I shouldn't have come.
No, it's Christmas time. Goodwill to men and all that. Would you like to come in?
No. I just need to know. Is he good enough?
For what?
I don't know. For the school? For the audition?
Well, we'll never know, will we? Maybe he'd have gotten in. Maybe he'd have joined the Bally Room there. Maybe he'd have ended up in a scrap heap like everybody else. How the hell should I know?
So there's nothing we can do then.
Wait. Actually, if we move fast enough, I could probably still get him an audition in London.
So it's not too late then?
No.
So how much is this going to cost then, this ballet school lark?
About $5,000, plus living expenses, but sometimes the local authority pay the tuition costs.
$5,000? I was talking about the audition.
Oh, that's nothing. That's like 20 quid or something.
$5,000? We haven't even got enough money for the bus fare to London.
Listen, if it's just a question of bus fare, I'm happy. Piss off, Debbie! I'm busy!
No. I don't want your money. I didn't come here for charity. He's my son, isn't he?
For Christ's sakes. When are you gonna get over your ignorant, working-class pride? Your son is gifted. He's got a chance. What have you got to offer him? What, mining? This town has had it now. We're finished. We're fighting this battle that was lost years ago. And I'm not the enemy, Mr. Elliot. We're all in this together. So for God's sakes, just talk to me and let me help.
I want to thank you for everything that you've done for our Billy. I really appreciate it.
Is that it then? This is ridiculous. Why don't you come inside and we'll talk this over?
No. You're right. He's my responsibility.
Ma'am! Saw you then. See if I care.
Merry bloody Christmas.
Right, let's be having you. Gormley.
Aye.
Atkinson.
Yep.
Summers. Summers. I haven't seen you here before.
Jockey. Jockey Elliot. Wasn't expecting to see you here.
Aye. Things change, don't they?
Yeah. Well, who's the big man now, huh?
Piss off, will ya?
Right then, all aboard the Skylark.
They're coming, then! They're coming! Let's go!
Go on! Oh, my God! Oh, my God!
What are you doing?
Come on!
What are you doing?
Shut up! Jack, where are you going?
Thank you.
can't take it anymore, son. This is tearing me apart. We lost. We're finished, man. We're through.
Jesus
Christ. We need to give the kid a future. I need to look him in the eye. Believe me, son, I'd do the same for you.
And give it now, Dad. We've all been out a year.
Yeah, that's right!
I'll never be able to talk to you again. You can't do this to me, Dad. You can't do it to yourself. He's just a kid. He's only just a man.
Whatever God he could shine for all we know. We don't know how far he could go. And no one else can give what I can give. No one else can give what I can give. He could go and he could shine, not just stay here counting time. We have got the chance to let him live. Yes, we've got the chance to let him live.
Is it about us, Dad? It's not about the kid. This is all of us. It's everybody's chance.
Come on, people of our community!
It's everybody's past. It's not about a bin who wants to dance. It's about our history. It's about all right.
Here forever.
Think about the sacrifice we've made. It's what you always taught us since I was a lad. Oh, please, Dad, don't let that passion fade.
For Christ's sakes, Jackie.
But he could go and he could shine, not just stay here counting time. We have got the chance to let him live. But we've got the chance to let him live.
Hey, hey, what's going on?
What the hell are you two thinking of? Tearing each other apart? What do you think they want us to be doing? We should be helping the lad.
All right. What the hell are we supposed to do then?
Take this and this.
And this and this.
Take this and this, and this and this.
Take this and this.
And this and this, and this and this.
Don't worry, lad, we'll never let you fall.
We will go and we will shine. We will go and seize the time. We will all have pride in how we live. Yes, we'll all have pride in how we live.
Always stand together.
Yes, we'll all have pride in how we live.
You can't do that, man. I thought that was for the new punch bag.
Well, we support the arts. After all, just because we're a boxing club doesn't mean we're a bunch of Palestinians.
Philistines! Anyway, man, you're wasting your time scrambling around for 50p.
Hey, I worked half of the 50p.
Oh, you've never done a hard day's work in your life.
Anyway, we're not just scrambling around. We've
nearly got enough.
Haven't nearly got enough, Billy. They've gone off to the bloody hotel.
This bloody hopeless man.
What the hell do you want?
I don't want any trouble.
Yeah, get out! You're a scab in here!
Here, son.
The hell is that for?
It's for the bears.
Yeah, I don't bloody well think so. We're not taking anything off you.
Hang on a minute!
Billy, we don't have dirty money in here.
But this would pay for everything!
For Christ's sakes, give the baron a chance!
We're not taking it! Scab! Now get him out of here!
There must be hundreds here! Can we use it, Dad?
Go on, then. Go to London. Do the audition. Take the bloody money. What's that to you, huh? Well, screw! They already started going back! What's the point? What's the point in trying to keep your pit open, huh? What's the point in trying to keep your community together? What's the point in trying to keep your family together anyway?
So, can we use it, Dad?
This is it, then.
They said to wait on stage.
Bloody hell. Look at that.
Name?
I beg your pardon.
Name?
Elliot. Billy Elliot.
And your son's name, Mr. Elliot?
No. He's Billy Elliot.
You are here for the audition.
No,
occupation?
Miner. I work in a mine.
You mean you actually go underground? Right, this way, please. William, what is that you're holding?
It's me money.
Your money?
Me money for the audition. Most of it's in 50p's, but the rest is from a scab.
Thank you.
Oh! Here.
What's that?
A tape.
A tape?
A tape.
What for?
It's for me dance.
Dance?
The dance I'm gonna do for my audition.
Oh, there is no dance.
No dance?
Come now, we don't want to be late. Oh, just the children. We're holding auditions on stage today, thank you.
Frightfully nerve-wracking, isn't it?
I beg your pardon?
Well, frightfully nerve-wracking. You know, sometimes I get more worked up about these things than my Thomas.
We're first time like you now.
I beg your pardon?
We're first time like you now. It's our first, audition.
Oh, I see.
Dad, I've changed my mind.
What?
Mr. Fish!
Get back in there, you little sod!
Are you all right, Pat? Would you like a smoke?
No, Oh, hell. So, where the bloody hell are you from?
Glasgow. What'd you think? I came down here when I was 13. It's a way a bit nerve-wracking at first, isn't it?
Well, it isn't exactly what I thought he'd be doing.
My dad was the same at first.
I suppose he's used to it by now.
Oh, no. He's a complete arsehole. You get right behind your boy now, understand?
Mr. Elliot, we're ready for you now. Mr. Elliot! There is no smoking in here. Oh!
Oi!
Tondu second and hold. Prepare fourth, pirouette. Close fifth and hold. Thank you.
Can I ask a question?
Yes?
Are you sure you don't want to see me dance?
We've absolutely seen enough.
But I've been
practicing. That's all we need, thank you.
Are you alright? It was a complete bloody waste of time. They didn't even want to see me dance.
They got all you need to know from the exercises.
But I've been practicing for ages.
Look, it was only a stupid audition.
It's off, man.
Hey, look, it's all right.
Piss off, you bent bastard!
Ah!
What on earth is going on here?
Shit, I'm so sorry, I'm sure. Nothing like this has ever happened before. Please, this way.
Please take a seat, Mr. Elliot. I'm afraid, Mr. Elliot, that mutual respect and self-discipline are absolute prerequisites of any pupil at this school. Such displays of violence cannot be tolerated under any circumstances. Do you understand?
Billy's very sorry. He's been under a lot of stress lately.
Just a few questions to finish with. Could you tell us how you first became interested in the ballet?
I don't know. I just was.
Well, was there any particular aspect of the ballet that caught your imagination?
The dancing?
He dances all the time. Every day after school.
Yes, we have a very enthusiastic letter from Mrs. Wilkinson. She has also explained your personal circumstances. Are you a balletomane, Mr. Elliot?
I beg your pardon?
Are you a fan of the ballet?
Well, I wouldn't exactly say I'm an expert or anything.
You do realize that pupils at this school are expected to attain the highest standards, not only in ballet, but also in their ordinary academic work. A child can only succeed with 100% support of his family. You are completely behind, Billy, are you not?
Yes. Yes!
Would you like to ask us any questions?
No.
Are you sure there's nothing else you'd like to say? Well, in that case, we will let you know in due course. Just one more thing. Can I just ask you, Billy, what does it feel like when you're dancing?
I can't really explain it. I haven't got the words. It's a feeling that you can't control. I suppose it's like forgetting, losing who you are, and at the same time, something makes you whole. It's like that there's a music playing in your ear, and I'm listening, and I'm listening, and then I disappear, and then I feel a change, like a fire deep inside. Something burst in me wide open, impossible to hide. And suddenly, I'm flying, flying like a bird, like electricity. Electricity sparks inside of me, and I'm free. I'm free. getting all mixed up and mad as hell. It's like when you've been crying and you're empty and you're full. I don't know what it is, it's hard to tell. It's like that there's a music playing in your ear, but the music is impossible, impossible to hear. But then I feel it moving, like burning deep inside. Something burst in me, wild one, impossible to hide. And suddenly I'm flying, flying like a bird, like electricity. Electricity sparks inside of me.
Baggy, baggy, baggy!
Oh,
how
How did you get our audition?
Fine. Fingers crossed, eh?
Yeah, thanks, Leslie.
Hey, Billy, let's get out of here.
Oi, Billy. Have you heard anything yet?
No, not yet.
Don't worry, Bonnie lad. I'm sure you'll get in.
Ow!
I thought you said he was some sort of genius.
Genius, is he? Bollocks! If I was father, I'd break his legs for him.
Never mind, kiddo. Jackie, we've lost to everything.
So that's it then. All year.
It'll be all right, Dad.
All right. Billy, when you come back, everybody you know will be out of work. in this village, the next village, the village after that, and the village after that. And by the time you're my age, there won't be a pit left open in the whole country. Who finished? We're dinosaurs. 200,000 men! We can't all be bloody dancers.
Come on. Let's get down to the hall.
Anyway, congratulations, Bonnie Lad! I always said you'd get in. Anyway, I better be getting down there.
You all right, son?
I'm scared, Grandma.
Scared? What are you scared of?
I just want to know if I want to go. Can't I just stay here?
Oh, no, no, we can't stay here. We've already rented out your room.
Not funny, Grandma.
They sent us a letter when it happened.
Look, Miss, I know I should have come earlier,
no,
but you
I
know...
I can imagine. Toilet break, girls. Debbie, go on.
Well, Miss, I just wanted to say thanks, Miss, for everything you've done, Miss. I couldn't have done it without you, Miss.
Well, good luck.
Thanks. Well, goodbye.
Goodbye, then.
I'll miss you, miss.
No, you won't. You'll get there and realize what a crap little dance school this is and what second grade training I gave you. And you'll spend 5 years unlearning everything I taught you. That's all right.
Oh, miss, you don't understand. I'll come back and visit you every time I'm here.
Here's a piece of advice, Billy. Piss off out of here. Start everything afresh and don't look back. There's just salt left for you here. You're very, very special. Piss off before I start to cry.
Okay.
And good luck, Billy.
And good luck as well, miss.
Thanks. Thanks, Bill.
Thanks, Tony.
See you, sunshine.
Thank you. handsome boy. Thank you.